So it's Keith here. It's plugged on, kind of, sort of. This is my personal channel. I'll put links to the plugged on channel in the description. So I'm making this list because today is Monday, March 13th. And today, as I'm filming this, as far as I'm aware, is the last day of filming Teen Wolf. The last day was supposed to be Friday or Saturday, but they didn't end up getting done what they wanted to get done. And like the wrap party was Wednesday or Thursday night for the 100th episode. They had a lot of the cast there. So I figured, because now they're done filming, that maybe we might get announcements on who is returning as characters. I'd do a list on the top 10 characters likely to return to Teen Wolf. My ranking. Before I get into that, I want to cover two things. I want to cover a certain Twitter account that's popped up within the last week. And I want to cover characters who are either all but confirmed to return and characters that are confirmed not to return. So let's get the kind of meaningless thing out of the way. So a Twitter account has popped up called Teen Wolf Spoilers, which is basically like this guy apparently who apparently is an intern for one of the old Teen Wolf writers. His boss got the script for 620 from Jeff Davis and apparently gave it out. And apparently he has, and he spoils a bunch of things, or he's supposed to be spoils a bunch of things. So, I have reasons to not trust the source, and I'll go to that, because there's like five things. So, first off, I doubt that Jeff Davis would send out just a script willy-nilly without having like an NDA. Basically ever since the fact that Dylan was apparently on set was kind of put out on Snapchat by a cast member, Teen Wolf's cracked down on spoilers. There's been very little in terms of like recent set photos coming out. There's been a couple, but like it's been mostly like a lot of the stuff that you see isn't really like of anything substantial. Maybe a couple things from either like Holland or Shelley or somebody like that along the way, but like the Teen Wolf cast and crew have put out very little in terms of spoilers. So I doubt that and how they've been, honestly, since 3B, I doubt he would send out the script. Like, maybe closer to the fact, maybe, but I doubt it. And the other thing is that this person can't prove any of this, because apparently if it is true, which I'll even give them the benefit of the doubt that maybe this is true, there's, he could lose his job over it. But that's neither here nor there. Also, the Teen Wolf Wiki / Teen Wolf News, which is a big news source where a lot of Teen Wolf news comes out, they don't believe it. And they've been reliable for as long as I can remember. I mean, I've kind of been followed that website since before season 3. And they've been fairly reliable forever. And they post news and like, yeah, we don't post anything unless it's confirmed. And they seem to doubt some of this. So I'm going to go with them. And there's a couple of things they talk about. So first off, a lot of the stuff they talk about isn't really news. The fact that Styles and Lydia are together in the end, not news. The fact that Corey and Mason are together in the end isn't news. The fact that, of course, that the older cast is going to be central, that's not news. A lot, with the exception of a couple of things, it's all relatively known stuff, like Derek being back. That's basically been all but confirmed. One of the things they talk about, though, is that there is a time skip forward, which Jeff Davis has claimed there is no time skip forward. So I'm going to trust Jeff over some guy who can't prove anything about what he's saying. I'm going to trust Jeff, personally. And he also goes and he says a couple things. So he says that we get to see everybody's lives after Teen Wolf. So apparently Scott's married in this supposed time skip and stuff like that. So he says that, and then he says that Liam is in college, which makes it seem like, okay, so the time skip is only a couple of years. So it's like, so Scott's going to get married at like 23. So, and he says that, oh yeah, but he also claims that we never see Scott's wife, that it could be Kira, even though Arden Show is apparently not invited back, according to him, but which other stuff supports that. And yeah, so, but those two things don't really match. Liam being in college means it's maybe 5 years later. And then Scott marrying within 5 years at like 23. I don't see that happening either, especially since it wouldn't be Allison or most likely Kira. I don't see that happening. And I don't see them throwing some kind of new romance in within the last 10 episodes and then having that be something that develops quickly into that. And the other thing he mentions is that the finale is Hale-centric, which I do not agree with. I don't know why they would make it Hale-centric. Why bring back characters and have for an episode or two, which he claims the Hales come back for seriously only for one episode, and the Hales only come back for the last couple episodes, and then make them the focus. Make the focus still on Scott. And he says that, you know, it's Hale-focused, and that apparently a death in the Hale family brings them back, which obviously means most likely either Peter or Malia. I don't know. I doubt that. Maybe Peter, but then Peter's already died once, so why kill him again? Malia, I don't know. Why would you kill Malia right before the end? I mean, I can maybe see it working, but it's like, that's just, I don't know. So I personally don't trust this. But that's all I'm going to talk about this. The other thing I want to talk about is, so a number of characters have been, I've had to rework this list. It's actually the third time I've recorded this, because a lot of characters have either been all but confirmed or confirmed to return or not confirmed to return. So let's do everybody who's not confirmed. Megan Tandy has stated that Brayden isn't coming back in 6B. She was invited, and apparently it didn't work. I mean, I know she's filming something else right now, so that's probably a big part of it, but apparently they couldn't figure out how to work it in. Which is fine. Brayden was never the biggest character, but it would have been nice to see her come back, especially with, as I'll get to it, Derek being back and that being all but confirmed. The other person is Victoria Morales, who plays Hayden. Hayden's not back. She was there for the first two or three episodes and then took a break. And then by the time it was around time to come back to filming, she started looking for other work. On her own accord, the way that it's mentioned, I think, is that she left of her own accord. So she's off looking for other acting gigs. So Hayden is going to have a limited role. I mean, she did return, but I mean, she left before the series was over, which sucks because, I mean, we never really got to appreciate her character too much. So now five characters have been confirmed to return or all but confirmed. So the two that are definitely confirmed are Agent McCall is back because his name was on a trailer on set and he was seen pictured with Lyndon Ashby during craft services. So he's confirmed to be back. Jeff Davis has stated that Gerard, Michael Hogan, is back and he's going to play a big role. That one is confirmed. The ones that are not so confirmed is Dylan O'Brien and Tyler Hoechlin. Dylan was posted on, as I mentioned earlier, was posted on Snapchat that he was on set. There's also that video of Tyler and Dylan playing baseball, supposedly on set. And then they're also looking for body doubles for both of them, photo doubles. And so that kind of makes, oh yeah, they're back. They're basically back. I mean, there hasn't been an official confirmation, but they're all but confirmed to be back. The other person is Deucalion, because Gideon Emery is in the picture for the episode 100 wrap. Which isn't necessarily weird, but there wasn't, like, in a group shot where they didn't have, like, every cast member in the photo, he's in the shot, but that seemed like mostly of people who are currently on set. So, it doesn't seem like, you know, he would be there just to be there. It seems like he's back. I think that's all but confirmed. Which is cool. I love Deucalion. Deucalion's one of my favorite things about season 3A. So, those are all the characters that are confirmed to either return or not. Let's go to my list. So this is 10 characters who should return to Teen Wolf. So number 10, I have Allison. There's literally only one scenario where bringing Allison back would work, and that is through some kind of like dream sequence, a flashback, which I don't know how that would work. I mean, in new material, a flashback or like a hallucination. Think like if you've ever seen Final Fantasy VII Advent Children, think that. You know, Cloud in that movie sees Aerith and Zack in like, you know, and he hallucinates and has conversations with them. Maybe Scott ends up in the white room and he sees Allison and they have one last conversation and like maybe that gives Scott the will to fight or something. And so that's the only way. Because if you bring her back from the dead, that cheapens her sacrifice and I would not like it. It would be very hard to get me on board with that, I'll say. I'm not going to say that it's impossible for me to not like it, but it'd be very hard to get me on board with just bringing her back for three episodes. Next, number 9, I have Kira. Kira's actually a little bit higher on my list, but recent developments have kind of pushed her back. So Kira coming back could be cool because she would be a recurring character, and it seemed like the Teen Wolf writers were always writing her as a recurring character anyway. They never seemed to know what to do with her character. So maybe bringing her back could be cool, and then, you know, seeing her and Scott get together and that being, you know, the end game, as people like to call it, that would be kind of nice. But there's a lot going against that, which is, how do you bring Kira back without her just seeming like you're bringing her back so that she can get together with Scott? Stuff like that. And other issues, like, what do you do with her? The one thing about this list, and I'm going to say this now, and I'll probably repeat it a bunch on this list, every character that they could possibly bring back is going to be fan service. You know, a great quote that I heard is, everything is fan service to somebody. But I want them to do more with the characters besides fan service. I don't want them to bring the characters in and make it like, boom, like, bring Derek back, and now all of a sudden Derek is the focus of the show while he's back. Bring him back, maybe he can have, like, they can have, like, a big role, but, like, I want them to, like, do something besides just being there. And I don't know what they would do with Kira. There's also the issue of, she was written off the show by the writers. She's not like Colton Haynes, or Gage Golightly, or Adelaide Kane, or Crystal Reed, who are all actors who were either written off or killed off the show because they wanted to go do other things. It being their choice. Arden was written off the show because the Teen Wolf writers didn't know what to do with her character anymore, and they said, your story's done. So that fact alone makes it seem like they probably wouldn't invite her back, because at that point, why not just have her back for season 6 in general? And then the other reason is, Arden kind of, right around, shortly around the time of the like, the rap party, Arden made a couple cryptic tweets about not being invited to a party, but it's okay, I'm going to stay home, and not being appreciated. In which, people have reported, supposedly, that Teen Wolf doesn't treat their secondary actors all that well. I mean, Colton Haynes and Daniel Sharman have both stated stuff about this, and have both said stuff about this. So it's not unbelievable, maybe, that this could happen. I mean, it's a sad part of the whole deal, but, I mean, it could be a truth to the whole matter. So it's very unlikely that Kira's going to be back. Number 8, I have Morel. Morel's, like, the least likely character, besides those two, Morel's the least likely character on this list because she has the least amount of an impact. She's really only important in season 3. In season 2, she's just a side character who's mysterious, who's related to Deaton, is apparently, like, at that point, like him. And then she's in one episode of 3B. So she's only really important in 3A. I mean, there's some cool stuff that they could possibly do with Deaton, because I'm pretty sure that Seth Gilliam has been on set for 6B. I mean, It'd be a shame to not get him, since he's been a part of the show since basically day one. And so, I just don't know what they do with her. Again, what do you do with her? Number 7, I have Danny. Danny is the quintessential character of what do you do with him to bring him back. Because Danny's a human. He was never a part of any of the supernatural hijinks. Like, you bring him in, and either he does nothing because you don't change the character, and it's just a feel-good moment. It's like, okay, whatever. And what I mean, if it's a very small thing, like they just bring him back for like a short feel-good moment, sure, go for it. I'm all for it. But trying to have him like help the pack, how? And also, if they wrote him in like, oh, now he's learned, he's a werewolf now, or he knows all about the supernatural creatures, and he's like a hunter or something, then you're just shoehorning an idea in to justify bringing him back. And at that point, that's lazy writing. So, again, besides doing a feel-good moment, what do you do with Danny? Sorry. There is one way you can kind of bring Danny back and it makes sense. And that leads into my number 6, and that's bringing Ethan back. Ethan, you could bring back, because, I mean, he's alive. He's the one twin that's alive. And it's been noted a bunch of times that Max and Charlie Carver visit the set quite often. Like, it's not that, like, when a person leaves the show, they're, like, ostracized and people never talk about them. Like Holland and Colton apparently hung out for a long time. And I mean, Holland and Max were dating for a while. G.R. Bourne stated on a live thing that him and Crystal, he's had dinner with Crystal a bunch. And so it's like, it's not that like they leave and they go away, but they've been on set a lot. So that would make sense. And they did bring Max back for the season 1 premiere. And, you know, maybe they could do a cool storyline with Ethan where it's like they continue his redemption storyline. Maybe he finally becomes a member of the pack and he kind of feels fulfilled or something. And, you know, Ethan's the least, like, written about of the twins. Like, Aiden's, like, has the most characterization between the two of them, and Aiden's the most consistent, so give Ethan more screen time. But at the same time, the one issue I have is, how do you bring back Ethan without Aiden? Like, if you bring Aiden back from the dead, that just, again, like Allison, that's gonna cheapen his death, his sacrifice. I'm not saying they couldn't make it work. Like, maybe there's a reason that Lydia hallucinates Max in the season 5 premiere. Maybe that's, like, foretelling. But it's, like, again, it's one of those things where it's, like, that's hard to do. So maybe not. But that's number 6. Number 5 is Isaac. Isaac, again, this is the last character where it's like, what do you, well, okay, no, even some of the other ones are like, what do you do with the character if you bring them back? But Isaac, like, Isaac was big and important in season two. In season three, Isaac's a bit more of like, as like a visual representation of Scott becoming an alpha, about how he's following Scott now instead of following Derek. And in 3B, I mean, he doesn't do much besides get cozy with Allison. That's kind of what he does in 3B. So, again, Isaac would be cool. The other issue with him is that, which Tyler Hoechlin has both said this, but then he's back. But Daniel Sharman has noted before that he has no interest in returning. And again, his words about not being treated necessarily all that well at Teen Wolf, I think, adds some credence to that. But then also Colton Haynes said that he would like to come back. But who knows? I have Isaac because Isaac would be nice, but I'm not getting my hopes up. Number four, I have Kate. Kate's mostly like wrap up her storyline because, you know, she just kind of ran away in season four, and then Chris and the Calaveras went after her, and then Chris came back and it's like, what happened? Did you find her? And he mentioned Kate once earlier in season six when he was talking to Malia. So bringing her back, but also I want to see her and Gerard interact because, you know, Kate was important to Gerard. That's kind of the whole reason he returns to Beacon Hills in season two. But then he also has that mentality of werewolves aren't people. You know, they're just bodies waiting to be cut in half. And he forces Chris to kill his wife when Victoria gets bitten. So, you know, maybe that was so that he could manipulate Allison, but maybe it's his own, like, the belief that, oh, yeah, well, she's not human anymore. That's not your wife anymore. So I'm curious to see how he would react to seeing Kate as a Nawal. That could be a really interesting dynamic to talk into. And that's mostly the reason why I wanted to come back, because, boom, you can have that. You can have scenes with them together. Like, there's actual, like, clear-cut ideas of what you can do with characters. At number three, I have the Desert Wolf. Same kind of thing with Kate. Her and Peter haven't had any scenes together, and Ian Bowen is confirmed to be on set. So put them in a scene together, because, I mean, their stories are kind of intertwined, especially when it comes to Malia. That would work so well. You could also implicate, with very little like fanfare, and it would make sense, you could implicate the Desert Wolf in so many things. You know, there's one idea that which I'll talk to in my next point, but you could implicate her in the Hailfire, and it would make sense because she's angry that Talia convinced her to give birth to Malia. So she's like, I'm taking revenge on the family. And that's like, she tries to kill Peter as well, like, you know, because he's in the house. Or maybe it's all to kill Peter. Everybody else just collateral damage. Like, it would make sense. And Jeff Davis has stated that he would love to work with the actress again and have the Desert Wolf. So I feel like, again, especially in terms of villains, like bringing her and Kate back, don't give them a big role, but they can kind of be around. You know what I mean? Because they kind of did that with season five. Season five brought back a bunch of people and they were around and they were villains. Like, I mean, Gerard was a villain and it seemed like Deucalion was a villain, but they did it well. Like, do something like that. Bring them back, but give them like a smaller role. That would be really cool. Number two, I have Jackson. In all honesty, if Colton Haynes hadn't come out and said that he was invited to come back to Teen Wolf and that if it worked with his schedule, he would love to come back, Jackson would be much lower on this list. He'd probably actually be at five, and everybody else would get pushed forward, and Isaac would actually be a little bit higher. But since he's actually one of very few people who hasn't – he's the only actor who's been confirmed to have asked to come back and has stated that he wants to come back. He's like the only actor to do it. So that's why he's high on my list. But there's a lot of other reasons. There's some good things they could do with Jackson to bring him back. We haven't got to see Jackson as a werewolf yet, which is interesting. And they could wrap up that storyline on his parents, because Jeff Davis has stated that if he could get Colton back, he would love to wrap up the storyline about Jackson's parents. There's a couple of issues with Jackson coming back, though. I mean, Jackson's from the first two seasons. The first two seasons are a very different show than the later two seasons. It's a lot more quirky. It's a lot more young adult romance, angst thing type of show. And also, there's like so many more people that are on the show that aren't on there. Like, I mean, yeah, Danny's not on the show anymore. Allison's not on the show anymore. You know, even though he's basically coming back, Hoechlin's not really on the show anymore. It's a different environment than when he was around, so it'd be weird. And also, he's not like recent. Like, you know, going back and getting Derek back is just season four, whereas Jackson's like, you know, It's been for almost. It's been almost. It's been almost 5 years since we've seen Jackson on Teen Wolf. So it's like, is it worth it at that point? But I mean, who knows? It could be really cool. And the other problem is, it seems like they kind of like adapted and shifted his storyline over to Malia with, you know, her thing with her parents. So it's like, do they want to do a similar story again? But like with all these plot lines and like these ideas that I've given the last two ones, you don't have to make them a big deal. Like, you don't have to have Jackson's parents be a focus. Honestly, you can have it be like a throwaway line. I've heard a fan theory that Jackson and Malia are fraternal twins, and that's why their stories are kind of similar, and that's why they match up. And you don't even have to say it. You can just have like a throwaway line in it. Like, have like Jackson and Malia be in the same room, and maybe they argue, and then have somebody like Corey. I feel like Corey would be a good person to have. Just be like, are you sure you two aren't related? And just leave it at that. And then boom. And you can leave it at that. And that's, yeah, that's a cool idea. You know, Malia and Jackson were separated to try to both keep them safe from both Peter and the Desert Wolf. And then, you know, she attacked both of them because she found out where they were. And it's stuff like that. It could work. And it'd be cool. So, yeah, so that's why Jackson's number two. Number one. This one is completely because I just want the character back. There's not really much else reason. Well, there is, because there's a lot they could do. And that's Cora. Cora, if I had to pick three characters that were the reason why I love 3A, because season 3A might be my favorite grouping of Teen Wolf episodes, it would be because of Deucalion, because of Lydia, because that I didn't like Lydia season 1. I kind of started to tolerate her in season 2. But season 3 is where Lydia became my favorite character. And then Cora. I was really disappointed when Cora didn't come back for 3B, because I just didn't know. I just wasn't aware of the fact that she left, and it's like, oh, she's doing another TV show. Oh, well, that sucks. And Cora, there were a lot of balls dropped with Cora. You know, they teased the whole idea of like, she survived the Hellfire. Where's she been for 6 years? What was she doing? They kind of haphazardly answered that in 3B and said that she was in South America. But you know, why did she run? Why didn't, you know, she must have known that maybe the rest of her family wasn't there. Why didn't she go looking for people? Why did she stay away from Beacon Hills for so long? You know, there's a lot of questions that they could answer. And I mean, who knows? Maybe when talking about that Teen Wolf Twitter account, maybe that's true, because they said three Hales come back. So one of them dies. Supposedly one of them dies and three of them come back. Well, then that basically means that, like, if either Peter or Malia's back, I mean, Derek comes back, it means Cora has to come back, unless they bring Talia back from the dead. But they can't do that because she's confirmed to be dead. That's her clause that was in the Triskelion box in season 3B. So she can't come back. Unless it's Jackson, which could be another cool thing. Who knows? Which could be, but then again, you know, whatever. And the other thing is, I mean, it seems like Adelaide Kane's schedule's open. I mean, she's done. She got finished filming Rain in January. So like, I would think that her schedule is open now. Like Instagram and social media, she's not, like, she seems to, like, not be filming, but who knows? I mean, there's a lot of night shoots. Maybe she's available and she's done night shoots with Teen Wolf and whatnot. Who knows? Or maybe she was able to film. There was, like, a couple weeks time period where it seemed like she wasn't posting nearly as much. So who knows? Maybe. And I just want Cora to come back. Cora's my favorite. But yeah, that's my list of 10 characters to come back, or 11 if you include Aiden, but I'd count it as 10. And that's not even all the characters that could come back. There's the Calaveras, the Skinwalkers. I mean, I guess if you really wanted to dive into that and do some kind of weird resurrection storyline, you could have, like, Victoria Argent and Erica and Boyd and Matt. And I guess then Allison and Abe would be thrown into that. But the only problem with all that is, like, I feel like, again, that would just cheapen things. Like, to like, yeah, we're going to bring back characters for the final season. Just because it's the final season, we're never getting another chance to do this. I just feel like that's just shoddy writing. So I just hope they don't do that. So I'll probably do another video. I don't know what channel it'll be on when they finally put out a trailer for 6B. It'll probably be a little bit before they put out a trailer, simply because, I mean, again, they're filming literally tonight as I'm filming this. But who knows? So there's another Teen Wolf list I want to do. I don't know if I'm going to wait until sooner. But I have another one that I might do. But thanks for watching. Don't forget to go subscribe and like and whatnot on, and like videos on Plugged On. Very much appreciated. And yeah, I'll talk to you guys later.